Hello, everybody. My name is Red, and I will be looking at a review of Gone Girl. I will also be discussing how sexual assault was viewed and talked about at the time based on the article, and whether or not the article itself would be written differently today. The article in question is by Nikki Glaudeman. It's called Gone Girl's Rape Problem, and it was published in October of 2014. Now, before we start, trigger warning. This presentation contains discussions and mentions of sexual assault, and also a spoiler warning for both the film and book Gone Girl is in order. So, without further ado, let's begin. Basically, this piece was really ahead of its time in how it pointed out the harmful narrative about sexual assault survivors as depicted in Gone Girl. I think the only thing that would be different, say it was written today, would be that there would be further elaboration on how the filmmakers and writers perpetuating this narrative actually harm survivors, and how it conflicts with the reality of just how much the justice system is set up to fail survivors. Now let's look at the article itself. In the article, Glaudeman points out that the character of Amy Dunn alone is portrayed as manipulative, egotistical, narcissistic, and conniving. Now, I fully agree with this description. Let's be honest, Amy Dunn is really just a bad character in general. Her whole story is essentially faking being a victim of domestic violence at the hands of her husband, Nick, framing him for her murder, and running away while everyone, including her parents, believes her husband killed her. And she's just watching like it's a reality show or something. Like, ugh. Glaudeman points to one specific scene in the article that basically showcases the exact problem the film and the book has regarding how it sees sexual assault. Let's watch the clip.
So, she said you got physical with her.
No, dude. She said I raped her. First degree felony rape.
Did you do it?
Did you do it? Yeah. I was looking at 30 years to life.
Did you get a trial?
Fuck no. Do I look like I would do well in the yard? I pled down, man. Sexual assault one, no jail time. I've been unemployed for the last 8 years because I have to write sexual offender on every job application. I'm on a neighborhood watch list because I have to register as a predator. I haven't had a date in almost a decade because if a girl Googles me, I meet Amy at this party. We click. She's perfect. She's beautiful. She's smart. She's well-read. She's got an ass like a 20-year-old stripper. I think, what's the catch? Few months, it hits me. This is not going to be easy. She annexed me. She made me her business. It was just too much.
You broke up with her?
No. I just backed away. Gave her some space. No big deal, right? So I thought. Then one night, Amy comes over to my place with a bottle of bourbon and a bootleg of this band I love. And within 2 minutes, she's got my pants around my ankles.
They had sex?
Yeah, consensual. It was rough, but she was screaming for it. Next morning, there's two cops at my door. Amy has wounds that are consistent with rape. Ligature marks on her wrists and my semen. It looks like I've tied Amy to my bed and raped her. Me.
While in the book, Amy does drop the charges against Tommy, the overall narrative and the message is still the same. As Glaudeman writes, the suggestion is that the guy is so physically weak, he could never actually rape. This makes him seem like even more of an unfairly maligned victim, screwed not only by Amy, but by a justice system that overlooked the supposed ridiculousness of him committing such a crime. First off, no. It's not ridiculous to suggest someone like Tommy would rape anyone or could rape anyone. That is because the act of rape is about having control over the victim. It's not about physical dominance. And suggesting otherwise is It's just that's ridiculous. Another thing Glaudeman writes is how this scene classifies under the woman who cried rape trope, as it falls into broader stereotypes against women who report being sexually assaulted. According to Glaudeman, the narrative around Amy, quote, plays out like a ridiculously tramped up version of a commonly depicted and damaging archetype, the manipulative, seductive, clingy, vindictive, controlling, life-destroying, crazy bitch who makes up rapes and destroys men's lives because, why not? That basically sums it up to a T. As stated before, this article was published in 2014, and since then, we have made many steps forward in terms of how the media discusses sexual assault and those who are victims of it. While the hashtag MeToo movement was started in 2006 by Tarana Burke, it went mainstream in 2017, just a few years after the film's release. On the media side of things, I think we have done a lot better in recent years of depicting sexual assault survivors. Two portrayals I would like to highlight as examples of such is I May Destroy You and Has Been Hotel. And there are many, many, many more examples I can show you, but then we'd be here forever. So I'm just going to end it here. Thank you so much for watching. All my links are in the description below. Please like and subscribe for more. Thanks. Bye.